Hello everyone, welcome to Ticket. This week we check out Nightcry's Alpha and delve into the Askewniverse. Is Undertale heading to Wii U? Toby Fox has expressed interest in bringing his game to Nintendo platforms, but says the process would be difficult as Game Maker, the engine that runs Undertale, is unsupported on the system. Recently, however, Akinwa Lakuru, who is developer supporter for Nintendo of America, sent a tweet to Toby for an undisclosed reason, which led to speculation of Nintendo wanting to help bring the game personally. Toby has stated that a port would take time as he is not a programmer. However, Wii U developer Broken Rules, who were responsible for bringing Guacamelee and Chasing Aurora to the system, have offered their services. That or Nintendo have approached him to make Mother 4. Now, let's talk about the Coleco Chameleon. Last year, a company called RetroVGS attempted to launch a cartridge-based console using the shell of the Atari Jaguar and third-party Wii U controllers. They brought the concept to Indiegogo, where it only made 80,000 of an almost $2 million goal. Then they decided to rebrand and plan a relaunch on Kickstarter later as the Coleco Chameleon, after licensing the name from the company. Keep in mind, this is not the same company that made the ColecoVision back in the 80s. That company went defunct back in 1988. This company was created by a Chicago revival corporation back in 2005. Anyway, they announced plans to present the Chameleon at the New York Toys Fair, which got people suspicious as the system seemed to be playing SNES games with an SNES controller. It was led to believe that this prototype was nothing more than an SNES Junior in a Jaguar casing. RetroVGS denied these claims by showing a picture of a clear case prototype console with a board inside. A board which was proven to be a DVR capture board. So far, this thing is more tainted than a Chipotle left in the sun. So, like a chameleon, this thing better change its colors fast, or... Hello everyone, we got some late breaking news concerning the Coleco Chameleon. We filmed what you saw on Saturday, it was on the weekend, that I can tell you. Anyway, this is Wednesday, we've just gotten a report from Engadget, and Coleco have officially pulled their support from the Chameleon. According to Coleco partner Chris Cardillo, I'm reading this right off the release. Retro has decided that the work they have created is not sufficient to demonstrate at this time. Consequently, we can no longer proceed with the project, and the Chameleon project will be terminated. This follows another issue during the weekend when RetroVGS's other property, the Retro Magazine, its managing editor, left the company. As well as that, RetroVGS, the company that's making the Chameleon, have deleted its Facebook page and its website is inaccessible. Okay. God, I only covered this barely on the recording, but I have to make it very clear. This whole thing is a fucking joke! Okay, for God's sakes, pal, you took the damn casing of the Jaguar. Alright? God! Fucking hell! The Jaguar! That's what this system is essentially is. It's the third attempt for the Jaguar, alright? Oh, and speaking of Atari, Todd Schaubetter, COO of Atari, contacted Engadget with the following statement. Atari does not have, and never has had, an agreement with RetroVGS to release Atari 26 games on their product. Okay, this entire thing has been absolute bullshit. Okay, Retro,
RetroVGS, look, I get it. Alright, who doesn't like cartridges? I like cartridges. Hell, I've got my NES, Super Nintendo, N64, Mega Drive, etc., etc. on my setup. Alright? I like cartridges a lot. Does the appeal of having independent developers being able to release cartridge-based games on a console appeal me? Yes! It does! But here's the thing. Cartridges were discontinued for a reason. Alright? A cartridge-based console in 2016 is nothing more than a novelty. Alright? There is no way this kind of console could ever make it. Alright? You asked for $2 million, you made $80,000. Alright? And the whole, you know, the New York Toy Fair, look, just be honest, alright? Come, look us in the eye and actually be honest, please, alright? Cartridges, you know, there's a reason why we haven't had a cartridge-based console since the N64, alright? If anything, CD-based gaming, digital downloading have just made everything better. You got up to, because here's the thing, you can't update a cartridge, alright? You can't offer patching. It's not as easy as with a CD-based CD system or digital downloading. That would be fine if this whole thing wasn't shady as fuck. And with Coleco now basically saying, yeah, okay guys, screw you, we're done. Good move on Coleco, by the way. Look, you guys just gotta pack this up and just let this go. Alright, so we'll send you right back to our regularly scheduled kickers.
So, recently we were able to get a playthrough of Nightcry's Alpha. Playing as the lead character Monica as she leaves a party on the cruise liner, the first room keeps us in there until we figure out what to click on first. Graphically, the game obviously needs a lot of work done as her hair looks like it has a mind of its own, and you control her by using the mouse and pressing again for her to move faster. I spent a good few minutes just walking around the halls, going to the bar and just talking with everyone. And then soon enough, after someone gets sucked into a vending machine, the scissor man arrives and Jesus, Monica, you can try and emote some more. Oh, and here's an idea. Take off the bloody heels! The alpha ends with Monica hiding in a closet and playing the heartbeat minigame. So this game is essentially a touchscreen game made in Unity. Why isn't this on Wii U yet? Nightcry is being slated for later this year. Admit right off the bat, I've never watched a lot of Kevin Smith. I saw Red State once, but despite that, I am aware of Clerks and Jay and Silent Bob. So imagine a side-scrolling beat-em-up starring those two lovable stoners. Introducing Jay and Silent Bob, Chronic Blunt Punch. Being developed by Interbang Entertainment, the game is set in Kevin's Askewniverse, with Jay and Bob seeking an orange Julia stand, despite being banned from every mall in town, and beating up crazy-looking monsters. The game is being funded on Fig with a 400 grand goal, with 25 days left and needing about 55% to reach funding. While the awards are mostly typical, including Jay and Bob figurines, 10 grand will score you a part in Kevin Smith's next movie. Let's hope it isn't Tusk 2. Well, folks, thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next time.
Come, son of Jarrell! Kneel before Zod!
Snoochie Boochies!